Hey everyone, it's Al or Ariel. I am back for another bump date. Yay! So today I'm going to be talking all about week 6 of my pregnancy. Okay guys, so week 6. The first thing I wanted to talk about is how in my last video, I completely forgot to mention heartburn. I don't know why that didn't cross my mind. I completely forgot about it. But anyways, I definitely been feeling heartburn. That's, I think, been my main pregnancy symptom. But it's not even really that related to pregnancy because I'm on such a high dose of progesterone 3 times a day. Like, yay MGH for being so aggressive with their medicine. But, like, and I know lots of people are like, oh, I do progesterone once a day, twice a day, and it's like 3 times a day for me. So I know that's pretty aggressive, but that's okay. I'd rather be safe than sorry. So good old MGH has me covered. But progesterone definitely has been causing me heartburn for sure. It's been pretty rough. The only things that really have been helping me or that helped me last week were baking soda mixed in with water, and it tastes disgusting and tastes like the ocean, and because it's like salty. And it's just really gross, which is not fun when you're pregnant because all of your senses are so elevated that it's just like not fun at all to have to do that, but it works really well for me. So baking soda and like warm water has been working well for me, and Tums has also been working well for me. Definitely I've noticed what I eat has a big impact, so things like pizza. Oh my gosh, every time I have pizza, it doesn't matter if it's organic, doesn't matter which company makes it, doesn't matter which store it's from. Every time I eat pizza, I am an absolute disaster. Like, I just can't eat pizza anymore during this pregnancy, or at least right now. It's just been terrible. So heartburn's definitely been a big factor. This week I discovered something amazing, or I didn't discover it, but I figured it out, I suppose. So in my world, you working as a maternity nurse and neonatal nurse, we do use simethicone with babies. So that is gas relief, and it's so funny because I was saying, oh, well, it feels like the heartburn feels like gas bubbles in me that like just can't like I don't know, I know this is like not flattering at all, but it was just definitely like almost felt like I was like burping a lot, and just like I wasn't drinking any like soda or anything like that. It was just like it felt like these trapped air bubbles inside of me. Just definitely like upper GI gas, if that makes any sense. So I was like, I wonder if simethicone would help me, because what it does is it breaks up big gas bubbles into small ones, and then it doesn't cause as much discomfort, and they make a dose for adults. So I gave it a try, and that has been my miracle cure, guys. So, and it's super safe during pregnancy because it doesn't even get absorbed into your system. It just goes right through. It's like fiber, just whoop, like goes right through you. No big deal. Not to say that it doesn't like make you go. I'm just saying it, you know, goes right through your system. So it's not a big deal. So the simethicone has been helping me tons and tons and tons. It's been absolutely amazing. I got these adult dose chewable kind, and they're mint, but the mint is like really strong. So I wish that they didn't make them in chewable. I wish there was like a different kind. And I did see there was a different brand that was not chewable, but it was like twice the price because the generic happened to be chewable. And I really just was like, I'm not spending, you know, $40 on gas relief. Like, this is ridiculous. So I just tried out the chewable ones, and that's been working out totally fine for me. I'm still not really having a whole lot of nausea. Not to say I don't feel pregnant. This week especially, I've been feeling very pregnant. So I will definitely include some pictures into my videos to show you guys my progress along the way. It's kind of hard to like show you on camera. I did show you in the first week kind of the bump that I had, but I literally just ate a giant meal. So the bump that I have right now is kind of a false bump. But let me guys know. I mean, if you really want me to show you my bump in the video, just leave a comment down below and let me know what you guys think, because if it's distorted or whatever, whatever. But I've been trying to take photographs of my bump as I'm going along, especially when I like haven't eaten a ton and stuff like that, so that you can really see the defined bump, which is really cool. So this week in week 6, I definitely think that the IVF bloat has definitely gone down a little bit, but I think because my uterus has been growing upwards, it's definitely like pushing things up, and so it's definitely been interesting. I think that the bump is getting a little bit bigger, but I feel like it's less flabby than before, if that makes any sense. And it's really, really low. Like, the bump isn't super obvious most of the time from like the upper part of my belly. It's literally super, super low, which makes sense because that's where your uterus is during the stage of pregnancy. It's really, really low, and it's to the point where before I couldn't really comfortably wear jeans during IVF because I was so stretched out low in my belly anyways, but it's gotten to the point where I can't even like button jeans. It's not just uncomfortable, it's just I can't even button them. So I officially give it up on wearing my pre-pregnancy jeans already at week 6. So that's a little pathetic, I know, but whatever. And it's just like I could potentially button them, but it would be really uncomfortable. So I got these belly band things, and guys, it's just such a fail. It's such a fail. I don't know how anyone wears those. Like, I don't know. Unless you're wearing super tight jeans to begin with, there's no way for them to stay up properly. Like, if you're sitting down, you know, I wore one to, like, we went to the movie theaters together as, like, a date, and I wore the belly band with jeans to there, and it was totally fine. But then I wore them walking around when we went up to visit my parents in New Hampshire, and I was, like, constantly pulling my pants up. It was so uncomfortable. I was just like, I cannot do this. So the thing I've been relying on most is dresses. I'm actually wearing a dress right now. The only issue I've been finding is most of my dresses have, like, a natural waist and cut right in the middle of my belly, which isn't the most comfortable. I'm looking more for either empire waisted or not waisted. Like, I have a lot of kind of like loose fitting dresses, and I've been just belting them right underneath my bust to make it look more flattering, and then you can kind of see the bump and people can tell that you're pregnant, not just chubby, which which I always appreciate. Even though I am pretty early along, it's still good to know and everything that, you know, you can be like, hey, it's not fat, I promise, like, I am pregnant. It's always fun to do. So I'm lucky it's the summertime, I've been wearing lots of that. And then I was in Old Navy the other day, and they do have a maternity section, but it's super, super tiny. And so I just happened to go through there, and there happened to be these shorts on clearance, and they are like a full panel, which I definitely don't need. But I tried them on, and they're so comfortable. So I, no shame, they were on clearance, I totally bought them, and they were amazing. And as I mentioned, I wore jeans when I went up to visit my parents in New Hampshire this past weekend, but I brought the shorts with me too, and I wore those all during one of the days, and they were so comfortable. So that was amazing and epic. So I say, girls, if women, whatever, when out there, if you're pregnant, even early stages of pregnancy, have no shame about it, guys. If you're bloated from IVF or from whatever, or from pregnancy this early, just wear maternity clothes. There's no shame in it. Like, you're pregnant. Doesn't matter how early you are. You're pregnant. You're bloated. It's not necessarily baby yet. It's a lot of bloat, but that comes with being pregnant. So I say, just like, you know, let the shame go, guys, and just wear comfortable clothing. Because, gosh, man, it's, you know, the one time in your life you can get away with constantly wearing spandexy things. Like, why not? So anyways, and then in terms of that, I just felt like I was stretching so much so quickly, which was surprising to me, but my mom, my dad said that my mom stretched really fast. Like, you could tell she was pregnant really quickly with all her pregnancies. So not super surprised by that. Some of that's genetic. But I really wanted to get something to potentially prevent stretch marks. So I listened to all of the advice of everyone on the planet, and I went out and I bought myself some bio oil, and I've been using that. I gotta say, I really like the smell of it. Like, it might just be pregnant me, I don't know, but it has a really nice smell. And I feel like it makes me smell like I'm wearing perfume all the time, which isn't a bad thing, because the other interesting thing is I've been using a lot more deodorant than usual. I use an all-natural deodorant, and it used to work perfectly fine for me, just once a day, whatever. And now I feel like I'm kind of putting it on more than once a day, but again, I think that goes back to just, I'm like producing more oil, and that makes sense. Like, as you can see, my hair is still having its oily problems. I've been wearing it up a lot, like in ponytails or buns, because then you can't really tell that my hair is oily. But I definitely still need to get myself a new shampoo. I think that's definitely part of it. So then in terms of nausea, I definitely haven't been having much morning sickness. I haven't had a ton of nausea. I still have little waves of nausea every now and then. It seems to be more when I'm doing a lot, I get nauseous. So I used to be able to just kind of like run around and get a whole bunch of stuff done at once. And now it's like I find if I do too much, I have to sit down and I get nauseous from it. I almost feel like that's my body's way of telling me to just slow down and relax a little bit, which I think is a good thing. The other thing I find hilarious, and I don't know if I mentioned this in any of my other videos, is my insomnia is gone. Like, oh my gosh, that is the best perk of pregnancy by far. I've been dealing with insomnia since I was in like middle school. Literally, you could find diary entries of me being like, I can't sleep. And it's crazy. So my mom also had that issue, so it definitely is kind of a genetic thing for me. So I've always been jealous of people that can just like hit the pillow and are out, and that is totally 100% me. The only times I have issues is when I try to go to bed earlier than usual, like a couple hours earlier than usual if I have a night off, and I have like heartburn or something, then that kind of prevents me from sleeping. But other than that, oh my gosh, I get home from work and it's literally like, I sometimes fall asleep with my phone in my hand, because I mean to like set an alarm for myself or whatever, and I'll literally just, like I'll literally lay in the bed and my body's just out. It's hilarious to me. I used to have to take like melatonin and L-theanine and Benadryl and all these different, like tryptophan and all these things, and obviously I knew I wasn't gonna take that stuff during pregnancy other than maybe a really low dose of melatonin now and then, but I haven't needed anything at all, and that has been such a blessing. Like, I am out and nothing wakes me up for like a solid 8 or 9 hours, and it feels so good to wake up refreshed. Like, oh, so epic. The other downside though is that I did give up caffeine and I have been tired. So I wasn't really super into caffeine before, even as a nurse. Like, I did drink coffee, but just not a ton of it, maybe like a cup a day, and never at the same time every day, just kind of whenever I needed a little pick me up. So it's not like I couldn't get through it without coffee, and I don't think that that's why I'm tired. I think it's the pregnancy that's making me tired. But anyway, so I've definitely been having more sleepiness for sure. Like, I get, when I wake up, I have like maybe 3 or 4 hours of being bright and cheery and chipper and everything. And then I'm yawning, and then I just want to like lay down for a bit. I don't actually take naps. I've never been much of a nappy person. I can't really take naps, but I do just kind of like lay down and sprawl out on the couch for a little bit and then get back up and continue on with whatever's going on that day or that evening. So that's what's been going on with that. So definitely lots of the exhaustion. And then in terms of the nausea, I've just noticed that eating frequently definitely helps. Eating before I'm hungry helps, because I've noticed the hungrier I am, the more sick I feel. I would almost put it as like, it feels a little bit like a mild hangover every day, which is super ironic because obviously I'm not drinking. I haven't had a drop to drink in like, you know, what is it? Yeah, like 6 weeks. Yeah, I haven't had a drop to drink in 6 weeks. So I mean, clearly it's not obviously a hangover, but that's kind of what I would equate it to. It's not like you're dying of a hangover. It's more like a really mild, like, ooh, some things just don't settle right in my stomach. Or ooh, I'm just kind of like generally queasy and things don't smell good. But that's kind of how I've been feeling. That's kind of been the worst of it. And everyone has been saying, oh, when you hit 7 weeks, that's when you're gonna get really sick. And I'm kind of hoping that's not what happens, but I am officially 7 weeks, so this bump date was all about 6 weeks, and that's it for now, guys. And let me know what's been working for you, how are you guys doing in your cycles, and that's it for now, and if you like, subscribe. Bye!